again. Good morning, everybody! Yeah. Much better. Good to have and see everybody here this morning for our Christmas program. As you can see, the kids are all decked or their costumes on. They normally dress as me on Sundays. No. But we're going to start off our worship time this morning with a song, so we'd love you to join in with us. Please stand and sing. Carol. It wasn't the same without you guys. I called the reserves, had Sharon come in. Not the same without you. Also coming up on Tuesday night is our Christmas Eve service. Pastor Mike and our new pastor Dan will be doing a service together, all three of us. So at 7 o'clock, please come for our Christmas Eve service. Okay? And what else? Oh, New Year's Eve. We're in plans bingo. New Year's Eve. So come 6 o'clock, we'll get together and get the bingo cards handed out, and we'll play bingo for several hours. Mike.
Is it Tuesday night or Monday night? Because Christmas is Tuesday.
Tomorrow's Christmas Eve. Yeah, it's Monday night. Did I say Tuesday?
Yes.
Christmas Eve, sorry.
Christmas Eve or New Year's Eve?
Christmas Eve for a Christmas Eve service. New Year's Eve for a New Year's Eve party. Yeah, it's on the 31st, okay? If they pay bingo, another date too. For the bingo, though, we ask you to bring a white elephant gift. It's kind of our prizes that we use for people to win playing bingo. And just have a good time hanging out, fellowshipping. And then we will have a New Year's prayer at midnight. Welcome in the new year. I think that's all for my announcements. But prayer request. Do we have any prayer requests for today? Michael.
I gotta pray. We handed out 200 Christmas cards handmade to kids in school and kids here and adults. So praise be to God. Hopefully I have to make twice as many next year.
Yes. Hey, thank you, Michael, for making all those cards. Yep. Good News Club is on Thursdays. I bring grade school kids here to the church and have a Bible story. We have over 32 kids signed up right now for Good News Club. 22 people, so yes, we crammed the bus full of kids. They're small. They fit together, you know. It's like two, we fit four in a row. Kelly.
Servants, would you please go to the back? This is our time for the communion meditation. If you'd please head on to the back, we would appreciate it. This is called Don't Overlook Salvation.
Cross for us.
that we live, we serve a Savior that died on the cross for our sins, who loves us so much that He is powerful too, that He's not dead. We serve a risen Savior. And that's a gift that God's given us. It's the greatest gift, actually, that God has given us. In Acts chapter 20, verse 35, it says, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." So, let me get this thing clear. Jesus did not say bad or wrong to receive gifts. He just says, the one who gives is more blessed than the one who receives. But you are still blessed, much more blessed, if you are the receiver side of a gift. This is good to know. It's Christmas time. As kids, we get excited because we receive lots of gifts, right? Right?
Yeah.
It's blessed. Jesus was saying here in Acts chapter 20, verse 25, but it's a new lesson to receive. And think about the greatest gift you received as a child. I mean, go back. Some of us are pretty far back. Right, John? How far back do you have to go to remember when you were a kid? Some of us are not so far back. Some of us are still kids. Can you guys think of the greatest gift you received so far? Not where we're getting there, Marge, but I'm talking about something your mom and your dad gave you. Okay, you're still skipping ahead of my meditation here. Okay? That's coming up.
Money.
Money? Did you receive money for Christmas? I like to play that. There's a game with you called Life, Share the Wealth. You give them the card and they get money, share the wealth.
Birth.
Yeah. These gifts, you know, things are received like money at Christmas or gift cards. You know, you gotta remember, you know, I like those gifts. But the giver is more blessed. It says more blessed to give than it is to receive. Now, some of you already skipped ahead, Margie and Katie, to my next part. The greatest gift we ever will receive is the one that Jesus died on the cross for us. Of Jesus. We celebrate Christmas. Good News Club on Thursday. I told the kids, we're having a birthday party. I'm like, what do you mean birthday party? We're celebrating Jesus' birth. That's what Christmas is all about. He, God, gave the greatest gift, His only Son. John 3:16, right? God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son. Whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The greatest gift ever was Jesus coming down as a baby for us. Living like we live. Experiencing life like we experience. Except for the part where He laid down His life for us. None of us here have done that. Laid down our lives for everybody. So, in the Greek, did you know, most of you know, I'm not very good at pronouncing things, so I listened to the YouTube video on how to pronounce these words. But the Greek word here for happy, I lost my spot, is makarios, makros. I think that's how it's pronounced, Carol, right? Makros.
I can't see it.
That's okay, you're afraid, guys. Okay? It means happy. Okay? Happy to give. And God was happy to give His Son for us because He loves us. He cares for us. So we celebrate Christmas because we have a God gave His Son, whose Son laid down His life for us. And that's why we come to take communion to remember what He did. From His body to His blood. Remember how much He loves us. We pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank You so much for what You did for us. Help us all not to take it for granted, to overlook it, that You, Jesus, laid down Your life for us. That we remember Your birth this time of year. We celebrate Your birthday by giving gifts and receiving gifts because of what You did. But Lord, like I said,
Please help us not to forget that. Help us to live our lives for you. Because you loved us. And because now we love you. We've accepted you.